Most data integration solutions have a lot of moving pieces and can get very complex, which also means it can fail for any number of reasons. As such, being able to rerun failed activities or reprocess updated data is a necessity. Gaurav Mahotra is here to show us how you can rerun an entire pipeline or start from an activity within the pipeline today on Azure Friday. Hello, this is Lara Rebelke, and today on Azure Friday, I have Gaurav Mahotra, who's going to show us some great new updates in Azure Data Factory to help you rerun activities within your pipeline.
Yes.
Talk to us about what you've built.
So essentially, with data integration solutions, failure is an important part of any data integration process where your activities inside your data integration workflows could fail because an upstream system is not responding, or data might arrive late, or in certain situations, they have run to completion, but you find out that there's a need to reprocess the data because there's some data integrity issues, right?
Right.
So you want to be able to rerun your activities inside the pipeline. So till today, with Data Factory, you could rerun the entire pipeline. And a pipeline could be as complex as if you see on your screen, like it could be a logical grouping of a number of activities, right? And here, what we are saying now, that instead of not only supporting just the entire rerun of the pipeline, you could also rerun an individual activity inside the pipeline as well now.
And that's really important. As you call out, these pipelines can take hours in some cases, be very complex. And
yes,
if you have to rerun the whole pipeline, you've probably lost your SLA for
yes,
for that pipeline.
And this is one of the most important feedback that if we look at our feedback forums that customers are giving, to the point that for them to meet their SLAs, they need to be able to run individual activities in the pipeline to support such scenarios.
Great, great. Yes. Well, do you have something to show us?
Yes, absolutely.
Great.
So if I go to the Azure Data Factory portal, and this is essentially we are on the overview page. So if you go on to the monitoring tab, you'll see all your pipeline runs as we have been showcasing already. And now you can see that as you dive into your pipeline run and look at the activity runs inside the pipeline, not only you can see the activity runs, but we have also brought the diagram view to the monitoring interface.
Oh, so you have good visibility and can see this.
Yes. Yeah. So you can see for that particular run, what was the pipeline definition you ran with and what were the activities inside that pipeline when you actually did this run. So you could now select a particular activity inside the pipeline, and you could essentially rerun from here, or you could rerun from the tab up above, right? So you could select this and say, yes, I want to rerun. And at that point, what it is going to do is it is going to start the rerun of the pipeline. It is going to skip all of the earlier activities because we said that I want to run from here to downstream. And once this starts, you'll be able to see that the first activities were skipped, as you see the status skipped, and it's also on the nodes on the diagram view. And the activity that we started with data prep is in progress right now.
Okay,
right?
Great.
So another thing that our customers came back and said that we want to be able to rerun the pipeline runs, and you can go back to all your pipeline runs again using the breadcrumb view. They mentioned that they want the ability to see whatever pipelines they have rerun, right? So now we have enabled rerun history for you. So you can come in and say that I want to look at the rerun history for all my pipeline runs that I have done, in which case, once you enable this toggle, you can see that I can see now three pipeline runs for this particular pipeline. Or you could keep this unchecked and say under the action column that for this particular pipeline run, I want to see the rerun history. And you click that action and you'll be able to see the entire rerun history. So you can see that the last four attempts failed. And again, you can go inside and look at the actual failure, and the entire, all the logs and everything is available for you. So this is just a link to your Databricks workspace where you can look at the entire logs. And you can just come back and look at the entire rerun history over here as well.
Great. Now, you showed a manual Rerun. What if I wanted to automate that?
Yes. So whatever we showcase in the UX today, it's a mandate, like with every Azure service, that it is available in the programmatic interface as well. So if you wanted to do this through SDK, be it Python SDK, .NET SDK, ARM template, REST APIs, PowerShell commandlets, with all those interfaces, this capability is available as well.
Great. So I can sense if some failure happens, I can automate that the response will be rerun that activity.
Yes. So you could automate this end to end. Yes.
Great.
Yes.
Great.
Is you don't want to be touching your production workflows. In most of the cases, people have these automation built, right? So you could essentially use those SDKs to essentially codify this end to end.
Great. Is there anything more you want to show us?
I think for this particular rerun, this is the feature that we have launched. This is available for you to use right now. We have complete documentation to tell you how you can use that. And we are essentially launching a blog post as well for this for you to know.
Great. Well, thank you again for joining us today and sharing this great new important feature to help with our data pipelines.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. We've been learning all about how to rerun an activity within an Azure Data Factory pipeline today on Azure Friday.